This is one of our skin models. Remember that we have two. One I call the 3D, three-dimensional skin model. This is a two-dimensional skin model, also called the purple skin model. The first thing I want to talk about is that there are two. This model is actually, I know it's called skin, but it represents the entire integumentary system, which consists of all these accessory organs that you see here, but also the epidermis and the dermis here. So on the side, there's a number with arrows, and the arrow ends here. So that means that this dark purple region, pink, dark purple again, white, and peach color, those are all parts of the epidermis. The line, the basement membrane between the epidermis and the dermis is not straight, it's convoluted, right? So this dark purple line here, there are two like typos or mistakes on this model. One's been crossed out by somebody with a pen, but there's a number 5 on most of these models right here that is pointing to blood vessels, and they overshot this purple convoluted deepest layer, the epidermis. So these numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, represent the 5 layers of the epidermis, and layer 5 is a stratum basale, and that is attached to the dermis over here. So I just want you to know that this is this dark purple layer is not the right here is not the dermis. So back to this, these arrows and the number. Number 34, I'm sorry if you're getting motion sick here. This is hard for me to do. It's a big model, but this is the epidermis with the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 layers. And then this is the dermis, and see the arrow ends down here. So the dividing line between the dermis and the underlying hypodermis, which doesn't have a number or arrows, by the way, the hypodermis is down here, also called the subcutaneous layer. The line between the two is not clear. So there's loose connective tissue kind of in both layers. Anytime you see red and blue, is blood vessels. So here are some blood vessels. And then if you look real closely, there are capillaries, in other words, blood vessels, in the dermal papillae. So the dermal papillae are these bumps in the dermis. And in this model, they're covered with the stratum basale, but in the other model, they're not. They're like naked. So I usually use the other model to measure, to assess you on a test for the dermal papillae. The other typo that I wanted to tell you about, the other mistake that they made, is that there's a number 8 on the hair shaft, the part of the hair that extends up above the surface of the skin. In other words, the part you can see on the outside of the body is called the hair shaft. Well, they put an 8 on the hair root over here. So just be aware that hair shaft is here, and the hair roots are this entire part of the hair that is buried within the skin. And then the deepest layer of the hair, or I could say the proximal region of the hair root, is enlarged. It's bulbous shape. There's a number 16 on it, and that is called the hair bulb. Around the hair, 14 and 15 and 12, is a hair follicle. That is not a region of the hair. If you will follow the epidermis, it goes down and becomes the hair follicle. So this is a skin structure. The hair follicle is a skin structure. It is not part of the hair. The three parts of the hair that you learned are hair shaft, hair root, and hair bulb. And then around the outside, this is the hair follicle in purple. This right here is an erect piloerector muscle, also called an erector pili muscle. It's attached to the hair follicle on one end and the dermis on the other end. When it contracts, it pulls on the hair follicle, which makes the hair move, stand upright, in other words, goosebumps. Associated with the hair follicle is a gland. Now you're going to be looking at a slide of the skin. And in the slide, remember that the glands that are associated with hair follicles that don't have a big open space, in other words, a lumen inside, are called sebaceous glands. So this is a sebaceous gland. Over here is an intact sebaceous gland that hasn't been cut open. This has been completely cut open. This is partly cut open. And again, no lumen in there, but in the sweat glands, sudoriferous glands, if you cut one open, you will see lumens because it's a coiled up tube. Now, also, there are two kinds of sweat glands, merocrine and apocrine. These are all, on this purple model, they're all merocrine sweat glands because they are not associated with a hair follicle. Okay, now, this structure and this one, there's some here. In other words, the whitish grayish structures, they all look different. Those are all sensory nerve fibers or sensory receptors. They sense touch, temperature. One senses hair movement because it's wrapped around the hair follicle, pressure, and so on. So those, we kind of just put them all together collectively as sensory nerve fibers.